What's going on, guys? My name is Mark Wagner, and today we're going to be talking about the niches that you want to avoid when you're getting into Shopify dropshipping. Now, you always hear people talking about the niches that you want to get into, sell this, sell that, but I think more importantly is what you should avoid, because I definitely sold in some of these niches when I first got started, and I know that that definitely prevented me from reaching success at an earlier stage. So let's go ahead and hop right into the value. All right, so the first niche that I think you should avoid is clothing. Now, clothing is obviously a huge niche. Everyone has clothes. I'm wearing clothes. You're probably wearing clothes. But, clothing is also super, super, super saturated just because it's so big and obviously it's been around for a long time. So really the only way that you can do well with the clothing niche is by having a specific, like, unique product with a specific target market. So for example, POD, which is print on demand, there's a lot of people that do really, really, really well with that. I know of a company doing minimum $20,000 a day with print on demand, which is, it's crazy, but at the same time, that's not something that's very beginner friendly. And that's really only one very, very small part of the clothing industry. So I definitely don't recommend that you should be drop shipping clothes from China, because clothing is very saturated, like I said, and people are most likely just going to buy clothing, like, unless it's something super, super special, like I was mentioning earlier, that has a specific target market, then people are just gonna buy clothes from like Hollister or American Eagle or wherever people buy clothes now. But in addition, if you are dropshipping from China, you're probably gonna run into sizing issues, because Chinese people are kind of smaller than American people. And for that reason, their sizing is different. And I've kind of tried to sell clothing in the past, and the sizing is just super, super messed up. Like, even if you convert it, it's just weird, and it's too much of a headache in my opinion. Plus you're gonna have returns because, like, you know, even though your sizing chart is clearly visible, it's just not gonna fit some people or whatever. But clothing is really just not a niche that I would recommend that you get into. All right, so the next niche that I think you should avoid is fashion accessories, specifically men's fashion accessories, but really just all fashion accessories in general. I really think that most dropshippers have had a store in this niche, whether they sold like bracelets or watches or whatever. Those are basically like the biggest dropshipping products in history of mankind. And that was kind of what got it started. And from my knowledge, that's kind of what blew up dropshipping, was men's bracelets. It's definitely, like, it was a profitable niche at one time, but now it's just super, super saturated, and I definitely would not recommend that you get into it. Now, if it is like a new and unique product, like it's something special, it's not just like a cool looking bracelet, like let's say it's a bracelet for dog lovers that's really cool because of some reason or another, then that's something that you can consider selling, because it has like a specific target market and it's new and it's unique. But if you're literally just selling like stuff based on the principle of fashion, then you're probably not going to do very well. All right, so the next niche that I think you should avoid is kitchen accessories. Now, this is a really, really big niche, and there's definitely some seven-figure or eight-figure products in this niche, but it's very hard to sell in unless you have like a ton of Facebook ads skills, because you can't really do it with influencers. Like, influencers are more for like a younger demographic, and those kinds of products definitely have an older demographic. But and it's also really, really hard to do with Facebook unless you really know what you're doing, just because kitchen, like the kitchen niche, has the highest CPMs across the entire platform. I've never personally sold in it, but that's always what you hear. And it definitely makes sense, because A, it's so saturated, and B, think of the people who buy it. They're kind of middle-aged to older-aged women, which have the highest CPMs like across the platform. So for that reason, I definitely think that you should avoid the kitchen accessories niche if you're getting started dropshipping. Okay, so the next niche that I think you should avoid is the health industry. Now, this is obviously a very, very big niche, but it's also very, very risky to sell in. And there's a couple reasons for that. A, is that it's pretty hard. You know, if you're making claims about your product and those claims turn out to not be true or it negatively affects someone's health, you always put yourself at risk to get legally punished. Now, that's definitely not something that you want, but that's not the only risk involved with it. Also, Facebook is really, really cracking down on health products, especially products that you claim to physically benefit you. It's getting harder and harder to sell those types of products on Facebook. And for that reason, I really just don't think it's worth it because it's probably not gonna be long-term anyway. Now, again, this is a huge market, and if you do it the right way, then it can be extremely profitable. But you just have to make sure that you're not setting yourself up to get sued or setting yourself up to really just like get your ad account banned or your business manager disabled or have a whole array of problems that are becoming more and more common with Facebook ads. Now, in addition, just keep in mind that you're probably gonna be dropshipping these products from China. And you know, when stuff comes from China, like there's always a risk that it's not like 100% good quality. So you really don't want to risk someone's health if it's like a product in that niche. And again, that just sets you up for lawsuits and other really bad stuff that you wouldn't want to happen to your customers. All right, so the last niche that you should definitely avoid is phone cases. Now, phone cases, that's not even a niche. Like people think it is, but phone cases are not a niche. I mean, who are you gonna sell to? Like passionate phone owners? It doesn't make sense, but so many beginners do this. And really, phone cases can work. Like I'm not saying that they can't, but you can't. Well, I really wouldn't recommend you have a store that literally just sells phone cases. So if you are gonna be selling phone cases, then I'll recommend that you have like a niche store. Like for example, you're in the dog niche and you sell like a couple phone cases on your website with certain types of dogs on them. In that case, it could definitely work, but you don't wanna have such a broad product and only be selling that. All right, so you may have seen some similarities of why you should avoid these niches, but I'm just kinda gonna reiterate a little bit and tell you what you should look for. Now, you really wanna look for products that have a defined target market. And whenever you are thinking about selling a certain product, think about the target market that it has. Do these people have buying power, or are they 12-year-olds who play Fortnite? Do these people have Facebook accounts or do they use Instagram more? That's going to determine how you advertise to them. Are these people really passionate about the niche or is it just kind of a side hobby for the vast majority of people? Keep in mind that in my opinion, the products are way more important than the niche because at the end of the day, you're gonna be building a niche store around a winning product. It's not the other way around. All right guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video and I hope that you kind of got a better idea of what you should avoid and what you should look for when you're starting Shopify dropshipping. I just want to thank you guys really quickly for all the recent support. It took me 100 videos to get my first 1,000 subscribers and we're about to hit 2,000 after like 2 or 3 videos posted. So I really, really appreciate that and it means the world to me. So thank you guys and if you haven't already, then hit that subscribe button below. So I really appreciate you guys watching and I hope you have an awesome day. I'll see you in the next one.